red button and subscribe. And don't forget to give this video a thumbs up. It's free, you won't be charged. So in today's tutorial, we'll be learning how to make a detachable handkerchief peplum. So let's get started. Measurements needed for this tutorial. Number one, you need your waist circumference. Mine is 32 inches. You also need your peplum length. My peplum length is 8 inches plus 1 inch for seam allowance. Then another thing you need is your waist radius. Now, to calculate your waist radius, you need your waist circumference. My waist circumference is 32 inches plus zipper allowance. I'm using 1.5 inches for zipper allowance. You can decide to use 2 inches if you want. Plus 2 inches for more volume, because I want my peplum to have more volume around the waist so that I'll be able to pleat it. But you can decide not to add 2 inches on your own. It all depends on you. So now I have 32 plus 1.5 plus 2 inches, which gives you 35.5 inches. Now, I'm going to divide 35.5 inches by 6.28 because it's a full circle. So I'm going to divide it by 6.28, which gives you 5.6 inches. So my waist radius is 5.6 inches. Now, for me to know the amount of fabric I'll be working with, I'll need to add 5.6 plus 9 inches, which gives me 14.6 inches. 5.6 inches, that is my waist radius, plus 9 inches, my peplum length. That gives me 14.6 inches. So the length of fabric I'll be working with is 14.6 inches. So let's get started. Now, this is my fabric. It's folded into two. So I'm going to fold it again into four. Now I folded it into four, and the length of my fabric is 14.6 inches by 14.6 inches. So now I'm going to insert my waist radius. Now this is what I'll do. 5.6 inches. I'm going to mark 5.6 inches all around here. So this is it. Now I'm going to cut this out. Now from here, if you check from here to here, this is what I have, 9 inches. I have 9 inches here, which is my peplum length. Here to here, I have 9 inches. So I'm going to cut off this part. So I've cut off this part. I've cut off this part. So this is a lining I'll be using. I'm going to do the same thing I did on my main fabric on the lining. Now I'll do it and show you, but I'm also going to cut this part. Now this is going to be the back part. This part is going to be at the back. This part will be for my zipper, while this will be the front. So I'm going to cut this part open. So I've opened this part. Now the same thing I did on this fabric, I'm going to do it on my lining. So this is my lining. I've done the same thing I did on my main fabric on my lining. So I'm going to put interfacing on my, I'm going to iron interfacing on my lining because I want it to be firm. So I'll do it and show you. Now the length of my peplum is 9 inches, but the actual length is 8 inches. 1 inch is for seam allowance. I'm going to use 1/2 inch for this part, for the upper part, and 1/2 inch for the lower part. Now what I'll do again, I'm going to join the main fabric and the lining together. Right side facing right side. Now this is what I'll do. I've attached interfacing to the lining. Now I'm going to join it with the main fabric, right side facing right side. Now I'll take it to my machine and I'll sew it. Now this is what I did. I attached interfacing to my lining. After that, I now turn my fabric right side facing right side. I place my fabric on my lining, right side facing right side, and I sewed it all around. But I didn't sew these two parts because I'm going to fold my seam allowance on top of my lining and sew it. I'm going to top stitch it on top of my lining. Now after doing that, I'll now sew these parts. I'll now sew these two parts and turn my fabric. So I'll do it and show you. One more thing. Before you sew your seam allowance to your lining, don't forget to notch your seam allowance. Notch your seam allowance first before sewing to your lining so that your work will be neat. I've sewed my seam to the lining. I sewed it all around. After sewing, I now joined this part. I joined this part. This is where the zip will be seated. Now, after joining this part, I now sewed this part. I sewed this part just to secure the waist. Now, another thing I'm going to do, I'm going to pleat my peplum. I'm going to pleat it like this. Now, there's no particular way of pleating your peplum. There's no particular way of doing it. Just do it the way you want. Just play around it. Now, after pleating my peplum, I'm going to attach my band to my peplum. Now, this is how I'll do it. Now, my band is 3 inches unfold. My band is 3 inches unfold, 1 inch for seam allowance. Now, here, I've ironed my band already. And I ironed in 0.5 inch on this part and 0.5 inch on this part, making it 1 inch for seam allowance. So now this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to attach my band to my peplum like this, right side facing right side. Now I'm going to leave 0.5 inch for seam allowance. Now I'm on this part, I'm going to use 0.5 inch, and that is this part that I folded. I'm going to use this seam allowance to sew round all around the waist. Then after sewing my band all around the waist, I'm now going to come back to this point. This half inch allowance I left here, I'm going to fold my band like this. I'll fold it like this and sew here. After sewing here, I'll now flip my band this way. I'll now flip it and use this part to sew here. I'll do it and show you. So this is my peplum. I pleated it and now attached my band. Now this is my band. This is what I did. I turned this part and sewed it and turned it again. And this is what I have at the end of the day. I've used my scissors to bring out this part. So this is what I have at the end of the day. Now this part, this seam allowance, I'm going to place it on this part and sew it from the front. I'll sew it from the front. Now this is what I'll do. I'm going to sew in between my band and where the peplum meets the band. I'll sew inside here. You will not see the stitches, but as I'm sewing, it will be catching the band underneath. So I'll do it and show you. And after that, now that's what I'll do. I'm going to sew it like that to the end of this place. Now I'm using an invisible zipper for my peplum. So this is what I have. I've fixed the band. Now this is the inside. I've also fixed the zip. Now this is the inside and this is the outside. So my peplum is ready. This is it. This is it. You see that you're not seeing the thread. The thread is not showing here. So this is the inside. This is what the inside looks like. Please, if this tutorial has been helpful, please hit that subscribe button and subscribe. And don't forget to like and share this video. Thank you.